The last year, skincare has been at the top of its game, and so many of us are just hopping on this train. So finding the best skincare products begins with understanding your skin. So for today's video, I'm gonna be helping you understand more about the skin to finally help you determine your skin type so you can choose the best product for your individual and unique skin. Somebody comment how many times I just said skin in that one intro. Hey guys, it's Elena. Welcome to my very first video for my skincare basics series. Very excited. Excited for this because it's my first like official series. The next few videos are going to be very basic skincare knowledge. So if you have any skincare questions, leave them in the comment down below. I'm going to try and answer them throughout the series. This is definitely a series especially made for those who are just kind of stepping into the skincare world and you're very new to this all, because I swear to you, skincare like blew up within the last year. I don't know what happened. Maybe like the lockdown, being by yourself more often, kind of got you into more of like a self-care routine. Maybe that's why a lot more people are getting onto skincare. So your skin right here, what you have right now, your beautiful organ, is what you're born with. Your skin is predetermined by your genes, but the state of your skin can change throughout your lifetime by some external and internal factors. By internal factors, I mean like aging, health conditions, hormone fluctuation, and external factors like your environment, your skincare routine, even the food that you choose to put in your body all contribute to the state of your skin currently. So these factors can either put your skin on balance or throw them off completely. A lot of people think that your skin is mostly determined by the products that you use, but actually your overall lifestyle determines the condition of your skin. And not just your lifestyle, but like your entire genetic makeup plays a huge, huge role in the condition of your skin. So let's start with the five main basic skin types. We have oily skin, dry skin, balanced, or a lot of people like to say normal skin, combination skin, and sensitive skin. Oily skin is caused by an overactive sebaceous gland. Your sebaceous glands basically create more oil than your skin needs. And yes, your skin does need oil. Your skin naturally produces oil to help keep your skin lubricated, to keep it healthy, to keep out unnecessary unwanted bacteria, to keep in the hydration, the moisture of your skin. It plays a really, really important role. And so that's why for people who have oily skin, a lot of natural responses would be like overstripping the skin with really harsh cleansers, overwashing your face, using too many cleansers. It's important to have a good balance between your skin. Don't overstrip it, but you want to make sure that you remove the oils properly that aren't necessary, that's causing some greasiness. Because oily skin produces more oil, it can look really shiny, it can feel really greasy, and oftentimes oilier skin has larger pores, especially in the T-zone area, so your forehead, down the bridge of the nose, and even in the chin area. Oily skin is more prone to breaking out. I know this firsthand because I have very oily skin. That's because when we produce a lot more oil, there's more of a chance that if we don't take care of our skin properly, if we don't exfoliate properly, it can get stuck inside of our oil glands, basically cause it to have this blockage, which can lead into inflammation and turn into a breakout. Very important things when it comes to oily skin is to make sure that you're regularly exfoliating your skin to prevent any blockage, to allow the oils to just flow freely. Ingredients like alpha hydroxy acids to help keep the skin from clogging, even beta hydroxy acid, and also niacinamide is a great ingredient. Niacinamide helps control the balance of your oils and help keep your skin moisturized as well. Even though oily skin is more prone to breaking out, there's an upside with oily skin. It's that we naturally moisturize our own skin. This is beneficial because as you get older, you kind of begin to lose elasticity. Your skin creates less oil and less oil and less oil. It lessens the elasticity of your skin. And it's widely known that oily skin ages a lot less quickly than, let's say, dry skin. Our skin can basically keep us younger for a longer period of time. Go oily skin! Dry skin is basically the exact opposite of oily skin. Duh. Since oily skin has an overproduction of oil, dry skin is the exact opposite, where dry skin doesn't produce enough oil on the skin. There's just a lack of oil production. This can make the skin appear dull, and can sometimes lead to some redness and some irritation if it gets to a point where it just gets way too dry. If you don't care for it properly, let's say you don't add any moisturizing factors, the skin can become so brittle, it loses its elasticity. It becomes more exposed to transepidermal water loss, which is moisture loss from your skin. And that's why it's really important to properly moisturize your skin. This can be balanced by properly moisturizing your skin. So not only hydrating it, but most importantly, making sure that you're using oils or something occlusive enough to keep the hydration, keep the moisture in there. Using humectants like hyaluronic acid, glycerin, stuff like that can really add that moisture back into your skin from any transepidermal water loss. But also most importantly, you want to make sure that you're using something occlusive enough to hold in that moisture. Because dry skin lacks that oil to keep in the hydration, basically substitute the oil that you can't create that naturally protects your skin from losing that moisture and letting bacteria in. Occlusive ingredients could be oils like this good molecule squalene oil. This is really lightweight, but if you don't like oils, there are other ingredients like silicone. Silicone is like demonized for some reason, and I hate that word demonized, like that is so rough inside the soul. You know what I mean? It has like such a bad reputation for no reason. I find silicones to be super lightweight. It actually looks very matte on the skin. It's occlusive enough where it holds in that moisture inside of your skin from just diffusing into the air. A moisturizer like this can definitely be a lifesaver because for people who have dry skin, a lot of the times it can feel very sensitized if it hasn't been properly taken care of. And anything you put on your skin, it's just to a point where it's so damaged that anything that you put on your skin hurts. A moisturizer like this can definitely be a lifesaver because it adds that occlusiveness that your skin's looking for, the hydration that your skin is looking for to keep it moisturized. And also, it doesn't have any fragrance, essential oils, alcohols. They're not like terrible, horrible ingredients. They just can be very sensitizing for people who have sensitized skin or even sensitive skin. The bright side of dry skin is that you obviously don't overproduce oil, meaning that you're less prone to breaking out. You oily folks like myself, that's more prone to breaking out. You know how annoying post-inflammatory hyperpigmentations are. Any pigmentation is very, very hard to get rid of. And for those with dry skin, you don't have to deal with that as much. I like to talk about a nice balance with skin, and I think everyone's goal is finding your skin's natural balance. And for those who have normal or balanced skin, you don't really have to worry about an overproduction of oil or a lack of oil because your skin just naturally produces the right amount of oil. It's that skin type that is very self-sufficient and is not really that needy at all. Since oily skin is prone to breaking out, dry skin is prone to drying out, sensitive skin is prone to irritation. Some people don't really consider this as a skin type. They consider it more of as a skin condition, but because so many people suffer with sensitive skin, I just chose to include it in here because it's just as important. Sensitive skin can be caused by any skin disorders you may have developed, maybe from even a young age, or conditions like eczema or rosacea, contact dermatitis. Because of this, it's more reactive to skincare products, especially with ingredients like fragrance, essential oils, denatured alcohol. Those ingredients can trigger sensitive skin. With sensitive skin, I definitely recommend to get to a point where, you know, before buying a skincare product, just quickly glance over an ingredients list, making sure that if you are sensitive, just to make sure that it doesn't have those ingredients. Look for labels like fragrance-free, essential oil-free, alcohol-free, you know, those are really helpful if you are sensitive to those ingredients. If you're not sensitive to those ingredients, it's nothing you have to heavily worry about. If you prefer to not have them, or if you're sensitive to them, or you're allergic to them, obviously stay away from it, but it's nothing that you have to be so overly stressed out about. So not everybody just has one skin type. You can actually have combination skin, which is the next skin type. Combination skin typically refers to an oilier T-zone, oilier forehead, nose, chin. This area right here is typically, that's called the T-zone. And anywhere outside, like your cheek area, it could either be on the dry side or the normal side. Having combination skin just means you have to put in a little bit more effort into finding a balance within your skincare. A lot of people who have combination skin and who like to do face masks, they like to do more clarifying face masks on their T-zone and more hydrating on their cheeks. You're basically targeting both skin types. An ingredient like niacinamide could be really beneficial because niacinamide not only helps repair your skin barrier, but also helps balance the production of oil. So it can be targeting both oily and dry or even balanced skin. Skin is not always black and white. Skin is kind of like a spectrum. Some people are more oily than others. Some people are more dry than others, but you can also have like combination combination sensitive. So you have three different skin types that you kind of have to worry about. Or some people have sensitive and dry, sensitive and oily. So now that you have a pretty good idea about the five skin types, let's talk about how you can really find out which of the skin types you are. For sensitive skin, if you're not already aware that you have sensitive skin, you might not even have sensitive skin, unless you haven't really played around with skincare products to justify if you have sensitive skin. It's all about paying attention to how your skincare makes you feel. I think throughout using skincare over time, you would kind of understand where your skin is at, sensitivity-wise. So another way to tell your skin type is to wash your face, wait an hour to 2 hours, and see where your skin is at. Does it look oilier on your forehead, on your nose, on your chin, drier on the cheeks? That could mean you have combination skin. If you have oily all over, that can mean you have oily skin. If you're dry all over, that can mean you have dry skin. Another way to tell is, instead of just looking at your skin, you can use blotting papers or thin pieces of napkins. After 2 hours, put it on your face and see where any oil has absorbed. Typically, if all the napkins kind of stick to your skin, all the blotting papers stick to your skin, then that could mean you have oilier skin. If it kind of just falls off, that can mean you have dry skin. And if it sticks in some places, like your T-zone, and kind of falls off on your cheeks, that could mean you have combination skin. Your skin produces oils to an extent. It just means if you lack oil production or if you don't. So some blotting papers and some napkins, you can see, oh, it has a little bit of oils compared to some areas have more oils. Even people who have dry skin might see some oil production, but just not as heavy as those who have oily skin. Everybody produces oils to an extent. Just because you produce a little tiny bit of oil after 2 hours, but it still feels very, very tight, very, very dry, that could still mean you have dry skin. If you're lazy to do, you know, all the 2 hour, 1 hour waiting, I know that could be a lot of time, is the pinch test. So you just take a little bit of your cheeks and you pinch it and see if you pinch and pull, not too much, you don't want to like rip off your skin, but if you pinch and you pull just a little bit, for those who have drier skin types, you're more on the drier side of the oil production, you might see some like lines and some wrinkles, but if you pinch it and it's a little on the smoother side, there's not much like ridges going like that, that might indicate that you have more oilier skin. So that is it for today's video. I hope you found this video helpful. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on the post notification bell if you haven't already. And I will see you in the next video. Bye! I have a hole in my shirt.